Hello, hi everyone.
Hey, hi, hello.
Okay, so I'm Daryl.
Kevin.
Yeah. Okay, we have this question from somebody in Malaysia. He's asking, when we own properties in Bangkok, then how do we pay for our monthly maintenance and utilities? Okay, every month, right, you will receive an electrical bill together with a water bill. Then this will be dropped inside your letterbox. Then every month, right, you actually have to make payment. So there are two ways. One is that you can use your bank and set up a GIRO account so that every month the monies are actually automatically deducted from your bank to pay for your electrical and water bill. Okay? If not, alternatively, what most people you do is that they leave a certain sum of monies in the juristic office, which is the management office of the condominium. Then the juristic person will help them to open the letterbox every month and then after that make these payments. But they will only make payment for the water and electrical bill. If you want them to make payment for your internet bill or any other cable subscription, right, then you have to inform them. Then they will facilitate this. Okay? And they may charge a small fee. Okay, so yeah, that's how you make payments.
So even if the house is empty and nobody stays inside, is there a recurring bill on the water and electricity?
Normally, electricity should have, because you turn on the fridge.
Oh, okay.
So you don't on the fridge. I mean, you don't turn off the fridge. So there will always be small amounts of electrical bill. And then normally, right, the meter reading is not read every month. So there are certain months where even though you don't stay, you still be billed. But later they will average off. So certain months when they don't read, they will have an average billing cycle. So almost every month you have to pay electrical bills. So it's important to inform your juristic person that you would like them to pay your bills for them.
Okay. Alright. Thank you.
So that's all.
Thank you.